I think I read War and Peace.
Okay. Good evening. Sorry we're late. We are going to open the Planning Board meeting of Wednesday, September 28th at approximately 7:35, 36 p.m. Currently in attendance, Marsha Wagner, Vice Chair, Pam Humphrey, Clerk to the Board, Sean Guerin, Member, Mark Marziotti, Chairman, and Don Johnson, Town Planner. I'm sorry, I said September 28th. I'm looking at an old agenda from something else. So it's Wednesday, October 26th at 7:36 p.m. Sorry about that. I just walked in late from work, and Sean did as well. So sorry for the delay of opening the meeting, but otherwise we would have had to cancel it. So here we are. Item A, approval of meeting minutes September 28th, 2016 and October 12th, 2016. I'm looking for a motion to have those approved.
I'll make a motion to approve the two said meetings, minutes of the two said meetings.
Okay, we have a motion. Do we have a second?
I'll second.
We have a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Take the vote. I just wanted to make a point that I looked at them and Joan had sent them to you by email, the minutes for the last meeting on the 12th of October. There was a small correction to be made to that, because you remember Sean brought up for a point of discussion about the next applications. And I didn't see reflected in the minutes that it was submitted twice, because remember, if you recall, that one was resubmitted.
Was it next amp, or was it?
It was one of the next amp.
It was
the Chartier one.
The Chartier.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Whichever one it was, anyway.
So which date was that?
That was October 12th.
It was resubmitted because
okay,
it was an abutter notification problem.
Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this vote, and we're going to let it fail, and then we will take another motion, okay? So when I say all those in favor, none of us want to be in favor of this motion so that it'll fail. So all those in favor, say aye. Opposed? Aye.
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 Okay, so the motion failed. Now, what I suggest is that we go back and have the October 12th minutes corrected, so we're not going to vote on those tonight.
They are corrected, I believe.
They are?
The copy that's in your notebook, I believe.
Okay. Well, as late as it is right now, we're not going to vote on those tonight. That's my recommendation. We'd like to vote on September 28th, and then at our leisure, we can read the October 12th, and we'll put them on the next agenda, okay?
Okay.
Perfect. Thank you. So I am looking for a motion to approve the minutes of September 28th.
I make a motion to accept the minutes of September 28th as written.
Okay, we have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Unanimous. Thank you, Don, for pointing that out. Moving on.
Clarification, because the application that they're going to build is the one that was resubmitted 2 months later, not the one that was appealed.
Okay.
Superseding application.
Correct.
Okay. That's it.
All right, thank you. Moving on to item B, waiver proposal / lot line changes, Tobin Farms Estates and Stebbins Drive. So, the last meeting that we had, there was a letter that we had given to the applicant of Tobin Farm Estates and Stebbins Drive, Ms. Petrinos. And is that letter here somewhere?
Yes. I have a copy.
I don't think it's in there.
Can I say something to that letter?
Not right now, Wendy. I'm just going to,
okay.
Well, you'll have an opportunity to share your comments. Thanks. So this letter was approved by the board of the planning board, and was handed, was signed, and was handed to Ms. Petrino's during our last meeting, which was October 12th, correct?
It was also mailed the day after, too.
Okay. But is that correct? It was given to them?
It was given to them at the meeting.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah, we had to change the address to mail it, but that's all.
Okay. So the letter is, the reason is the proposal to modify a portion of the Tobin's Farms Estates subdivision. Addresses Ms. Petrino's. Please be advised that in the opinion of town council, relative to the above referenced matter, the planning board, prior to scheduling any public hearing on the proceeding, and especially before taking any binding votes on this matter, should vote to advise Ms. Petrino's in writing of the following. That, number one, that on the recommendation of town council, Ms. Petrino should submit an application for relief from the planning board prepared by a land use attorney for which addresses the regulatory issues which are within the planning board's jurisdiction. For example, the planning board does not have jurisdiction to consider dimensional variances which may be required to split the one large lot into two smaller lots. And number two, that upon receipt of an application in proper legal form and supported with any required exhibits, the planning board schedule a public hearing with notices to abutters on the application, and that Ms. Petrino's and her attorney attend the hearing, making a presentation in support of the application, and be available to respond to any questions or concerns from abutters or members of the planning board. And finally, three, upon completion and close of the public hearing, the planning board can deliberate and vote on the planning relief requested, and if approved, impose such reasonable conditions as the planning board may require in its wisdom. So it's confirmed that this was received, and so I understood that this evening the discussion that was going to be had, or the only matter that we were going to deal with, was the application for of Ms. Petrino's to enter into a or to schedule a public hearing. So was that application completed and submitted?
Burton and Engineering is doing the application.
Okay.
They're going to get it to them, I think, by tomorrow.
Okay. So based on that, Ms. Petrino's, that's really the only thing that, I mean, we can give you advice on any of this. We can talk about it. But I think that the advice that has been given already is exactly what needs to be followed. Now, it sounds to me like there's some documents out here and
right in front of me.
And feel as though maybe some additional questions, you may have some additional questions for the board. And if that's the case, you're welcome to come up and share those questions with us, and we'll try to advise as best we can.
I guess, number one, that letter that was from the attorney goes all the way back to August.
Which letter from which attorney?
The town council. That was his.
The one that we just gave you?
The one that you just gave me was from the town council.
Okay.
Correct? That was going all the way back to that meeting last, I don't know when the last meeting he was at.
It was October 12th.
October 12th, okay, so October 12th.
Yeah.
But that was based on when he was at this meeting. But since then, you know, things have changed. I mean, I have the deeds right here. I have the existing road written right here, and another lawyer did it too, another attorney, Charles Ball, did it, and it's right here saying that I have the existing road. So, I mean, like I said, we're doing the hearing. I just have to give Dawn a check to do the applications, and that's basically it. I don't understand why I have to have an attorney here. I've spent enough money, okay, and believe me when I tell you, more than enough money between this land. Then I had to have the sketches. I had to pay them for that. I had to pay for the final draft. I mean, you know, I'm just, you know, I'm not rich. Obviously, I'm trying to sell my land. So, I mean, I'm trying to cooperate. I'm trying to do the best I can. I have in front of me the three deeds with the existing road.
So, is your opinion that, that you really don't even, that we don't need a public hearing based on the information that you have from these attorney letters?
No, what I'm saying to you is I don't understand why I have three deeds, and I have the deed on the existing road, that I own that road. So, then I'm trying, then, you know, they kept saying it's one piece of land, it's one piece of land, it's one piece of land. So I'm saying, okay, then let's just take the one piece of land and make it into two pieces of land. I mean, I'm trying, you know what I mean? I'm trying to get this done.
Yeah, Ms. Petrinos, I understand your frustration. I really, truly do. And I understand that legal services and engineering services are not cheap. I've been there myself. I totally understand. And I understand that you want to sell the property. And had this been done correctly from the beginning, you wouldn't even be in front of us. And you wouldn't even be looking at attorneys, at additional attorneys' fees. So my recommendation and the recommendation that town council had shared way back in, I think it was August or September, is that, I mean, it's possible based on what you're telling me that you have legal documents from an attorney that maybe you don't even need a public hearing. If what you're saying is our town council gave you advice on having a public hearing based on old plans, old information, old news, and there's new information and new news, you need to come to us with legal counsel and an engineer that says, here's what happened.
But Burton and Engineering did come in, have them come in. You know, I had my lawyer go look up the deeds, find out. They registered, I don't understand what happened. I guess they registered the one lot, but I never deeded it. No one ever deeded it. So it's not a deeded lot, it's just a registered lot. It's not deeded. So I don't, you know what I mean? I have the three deeds and I have the existing road, so.
So sounds like maybe you don't need to do anything, but I don't know that. I'm not an attorney. I have no idea what, I'm not sure where we stand at this point. So if you're suggesting that you have the information that you need and no further action needs to be taken, we need to have somebody tell us why that's the case. Because based on what we see and information from town council that this town and your tax money pays for shared with you is that you do have to have a public hearing, and you do, there are a whole bunch of things that need to happen that I just identified in the letter. So when you had Burton Engineering come, the last time he came here, from at least the last meeting that I was able to watch or attend, was the same evening that we found out, or that you shared with town planner, that the drawing that you showed us wasn't even recorded and wasn't public record.
What, the drawing that I showed you wasn't even public record? That, this has always been a record that I've
that had. Evening, Peter from Burton Engineering shared with us a plan that we had not seen before, and town council was, town planner was advised that, oh yes, we found out that this plan that we were looking at before, it didn't have your name on it. It didn't have you. It was.
It always had my name on it. This is what's very confusing. Do you want to? Can I submit this to you so you can look at it? Can you look at these deeds? I have my deeds right here, all of them.
Sure.
And I have the existing road. I mean, the existing road. This is what I don't understand. This makes no sense to me either.
Does the board remember the evening that Burton Engineering was here and shared some brand new information with us?
Yes.
That evening?
I do.
And shared earlier in the afternoon, late afternoon, with our town planner?
I do.
Okay. Sounds like we all do remember
yes,
that.
I remember.
Not sure why, Ms. Petrinos, you don't remember that, but That's exactly what happened. And that's why it was, we sent you back home that night again with no further addition, no additional information. And that's why town council didn't get back to us, because the whole thing had changed that night without any notification to the board or whatsoever.
Okay, can I ask you this?
Sure.
Though I knew that I had three pieces of land, I gave him the titles a lot. Long. He's had these titles for a while. So he knew I had these three pieces of property and the existing road. I gave it to him.
My understanding of that evening was what Burton Engineering shared was that it's not recorded, the verbiage is not recorded in the Registry of Deeds. Is that what?
The what? Say that again, please.
The verbiage of the deeds was not recorded in the Registry of Deeds, and that was what was missing. And that's what Mr. Peter from Burton Engineering shared with us. So that was right here at the meeting. That was new information to the board.
Peter's new to Burton and Engineering. See, the people that I've known there have left.
But that was new information for us too. So we couldn't rule on it.
I don't understand that.
There were.
Because I've had the three deeds. I have the existing road. There's no.
What Mrs. Petrinos is saying is that she has three deeds. One of them is for two lots.
Yep.
One of them is for one lot, and one of them is for the remainder
road.
Of the layout. And those haven't been combined into one by deed.
One of them is for two lots. One of them is for one lot, and what?
And one of them is to be the rest of the roadway, the remainder of the roadway.
Because that was just deeded. That was just deeded recently to me. You have to look on the Charles Ball's one. He had that. We're not supposed to say names on this thing, but the two wives signed the land over to me. That existing road is now mine.
Okay.
It's been mine. So.
Okay. So this says. The one that you just asked me to look at, Charles Ball, attorney at law. This was on December 28th, 2015.
Okay, so that's when I got that, the remainder of that road was deeded over to me on that date.
All right. So the plans that we originally were looking at, and I don't have a copy of those, from what I understood, the combination of those lots or whatever was in that drawing, that's this one here, Don?
Right here.
Okay. That's what you first came to us with, I believe. Is that the original drawing?
The original from 2010.
2010.
Showing the three lots.
Okay.
And so that's the original one when they first came in front of the board, correct?
When they first came to the board.
2010.
No. 2016, when they first came to the board, us sitting here, this
first
board.
First came to the board looking to.
That's the plan
lots.
They came to us with, correct?
You know how it changed, what we were talking about, how it changed when Peter came here two meetings ago? Okay? So, let me ask you this, Don. When Peter came to us and it changed that afternoon, and you were notified, and then we were notified when we showed up at the meeting. That, let's call that the new plan, okay?
Okay.
The old plan that was presented to us probably sometime in September when Ms. Petrinos first came to the board to try to get this taken care of, which plan is that? Let's call that the old plan. Which plan is that?
Two
is
lots.
That on the table?
Two lots.
Is that on the table?
This right, I think this right here.
Okay. What's the date on that, Ms. Petrinos?
So the old plans 2016, which is, you would think would be okay, because the last deed that we just rectified, or that we just read, has a date of December of 2015. So if this is the plan that you wanted to move forward with, then it would all make sense. However, this plan is the plan that you came in with originally, right?
I came in with this plan here. And then what I wanted to do was take, you know, because I said to my husband, honestly and truly, I'm not trying to, you know, get everybody like, quit, you know what I mean? Like, go this way, go that way. I'm just trying to make it easier. All I want is two lots.
I understand that. But just follow this path for me.
Yep.
So this is what you want. This is what you want now,
correct,
right?
Correct.
But this is the old plan that you came in with originally. And this is dated January 19th, 2010, where the final deed, one of the three deeds that you just handed to me, says December of 2015.
Yes.
So that has supposedly, you received receipt of that land on December 2015, and this plan that you originally came in with that was drawn is January 19th of 2010. So you didn't own the land at that time, or you did not have receipt of the deed.
No, I didn't have. I didn't have receipt. Because what happened was, He left there. That land was supposed to be deeded to me, and I didn't know. I thought that they were going to deed it to me, but they never did.
Right.
But then finally, I got my lawyer to get after them, and they deeded it.
I understand.
So that was the existing part of the land that they should have deeded over to me to begin with. So now you have everything's together.
Right. So then we later found out that this plan, even though it's stamped and everything else, and signed off by the planning board in 2010, and correct me if I'm wrong, Don, was never recorded, right?
Recorded at the Registry of Deeds.
It was or was not?
It was. There's a book, it's a plan book and page, and it's, I don't know if it's on that one or not. But
there's no text deed to it.
It's only a registered site.
Registered plan.
It means basically it doesn't exist.
Okay.
That's why I'm not a title attorney either, but that's the way I understand it.
And my lawyer said to me that it doesn't exist because I own the three. I just said to them, I said to my lawyer, you know, he wants a lot of money just to write down that. He goes, look, you can go to the planning board and do this, try to get it done your way. Because I'm telling you, you own the three pieces of land, you own the existing land, but if you want to pay me big bucks, then he'll. I said, why do I have to do that? If I have a planning board I can go to and say, this is my land, here's my deeds, here's the existing road. All I want to do is put it into two pieces of land. I want to waive the construction. And it's not a public act. No one can go up there. They have to take care of their own land. It's going to be deeded that way by Burton Engineering, that they have to take care of their own, you know, their own road, that the town's not going to come in there and plow them or anything. That's all I want. All I want is two pieces of land.
Ms. Petrinos, the reason why you have to do that is because our town council said that without documentation from your attorney, we should not, as a board, move forward.
That's a registry recording book and page at the right, left-hand corner.
Okay, but what you're telling me is there's no deed to it. So this really, truly doesn't exist. So as far as I'm concerned, this doesn't exist. As far as the board's concerned, this does not exist. So I don't even know what exists. So it's not three deeds, because that third deed you signed December of 2015. This plan right here says January of 2010. So if this plan doesn't exist, a plan pre January of 2010 is what is at the Registry of Deeds, and you did not own the land at that time. As far as I'm concerned, as far as the board's concerned, at this plan, you did not own the land at that time. Whether you did on paper or not, whether it was some issue with the transaction or not, and I'm really sorry if that's what it is, but on paper, as far as the Registry of Deeds in Worcester's concerned, at this time and at the prior plan, you did not own that land. It even says right here, owned by Suzanne Valley, Wendy Slingo.
Because they didn't deed me they didn't deed me the rest of the land over. And that's the deed that you just read,
okay.
Charles Balls.
Okay.
So they did he finally had them sign something to deed it over to me. So now I have all the land together. I have my the three deeds with the existing road. I own the existing road.
Okay, so where is the original plan then? What's the
This is what I want to do. All I want to do is make it into two lots. I'm going to divide it into two lots, and that's it. I don't want a third lot. I want it to end there.
I haven't seen what the surveyor prepared yet, so.
He's preparing, Burton and Engineering is
preparing
the final,
according to
a final drawing.
Yeah. Registry standards is what happened.
Yeah, he's doing all the, all the lines or whatever he has to do on that. And he's writing the deeds up, and he's gonna write that. It said, whoever buys a property would have to take care of the driveway themselves.
Okay. So, is there any way that you can find out what the deed prior to, or what the plot plan prior to this one looks like?
It would be the subdivision.
Hmm?
It would be the original subdivision plan. I have this reduced copy.
Can I just ask one more question? Because you're confused, I'm confused, we're all confused. But so until they signed that easement over to you,
the last
had two deeds. It was two parcels.
Her name was on the third, correct?
Right. No, I owned all three, but there was a missing piece of the existing driveway that was there. They signed that over to me.
And that's what the Charles Ball?
That's what the Charles Balls is. They signed that. The rest of the driveway going all the way up to, I believe it was to the cul-de-sac.
So how does that, I'm really new with this, so how does that make three plots? That's what I'm not sure of. Because I only see I'm sorry.
42
and 47, I'm sorry.
Right.
I had to say it once and then it finally made sense.
And I'm sorry too, I'm sorry that this is such a mess. I don't understand it myself.
Okay.
I have documentation to show I own it. I own the existing road,
Which it does say in there that it was never abandoned, that they could find nothing. Because that was one of the other questions, whether it had been abandoned at one point. That seemed like it was important, but now.
Per the site plan of 2010, I believe.
Okay, but the lawyer wrote down in there that he could find no evidence that it had ever been.
Within the deed, it's not.
Right.
Again, it's not
right.
Registered. So, without a quitclaim deed registered in the Registry of Deeds, it doesn't exist. Or, so it's the same of what it was.
Okay.
Again, I'm not a land attorney either.
Right.
It's just common sense wise, and being a landowner,
mm-hmm.
I can give you that much information. This is why I asked for a chronological timeline of deeds, ownership, from whenever to present was needed. That way we could come to a conclusion to say, this is what it is. This is what exists. This is 2016. This is what is here.
But my lawyer did go and check to see. He went to the registry.
Understand that, but do we
and
have...
And read and looked and said, we have three deeds. And you own the existing road. That's what he told me.
Does he have a piece of paper stating that? Everything has to be in writing.
I can ask him for something. I'm sure. I mean, he did. He went down there, and then I called my other attorney, and I asked him. He's like, He goes, you can just go to the planning board. You shouldn't even solve this with the planning board, where you own the, where you already own the land and the existing road. But if you can't, you can pay me X amount of dollars, and then I can come in and I can do this for you.
That's what the board had suggested.
Whatever transpires, I mean, if the plan possibly can make the correction, because whatever she's proposing to do to modify that subdivision will be on that plan.
On a new plan?
The one that's...
Or the plan that's, the one that's being drawn up now.
Being drawn up now, yes, that's correct.
Because she owns the three parcels.
If they show that on the plan, that they could be combined and the lot lines will be reshuffled or whatever, to turn three lot lines into, well, not lot lines, but whatever you want to say, turn three lots into two, and have frontage from an existing or modified right-of-way, whatever is on that plan. The thing about having a hearing is that no matter really what gets submitted, it goes in for a hearing and it's approved in the, approved ultimately under the subdivision control law. So the proposal is to create a right-of-way that provides access to two building lots. However they do that, they use what's there, they modify it. Modify an existing plan is what it's doing.
Okay, my question.
If the right-of-way didn't change at all, you could do as a Form A, A&R plan.
My question is, your
construction standard didn't change either. That's something else too, but that's
okay. Marcia, you have a question?
Yes. You're saying that it can be changed with a new plan. The new plan, like the engineering plan we're seeing over there, will have the legal names, legal ownership names on the plan?
Surveyor will have to do that. That's correct.
So we need a plan, a site plan existing as of today. And then a new site plan of what wants to be done and accomplished.
I think you could do that on one, actually, you know, show the old lot lines, similar to the way this was done.
Mm-hmm.
The old right-of-way lines, the new right-of-way lines, and that
you could,
sort of thing.
I think we could do that. But
whatever they want to do, it's
again,
a modification.
I'm going.
It goes to a hearing, and with notice to abutters, and the action by the board, and the advertisement, and the whole bit. That takes care of whatever is there right now or isn't there right now, because that's the plan that's submitted will be what is proposed.
Yeah, the only issue I personally have is that we specifically asked town council for his recommendation on how we should handle this as a board, because we don't have the ability, we don't have the law degree to make the proper recommendations. So we paid town council to give us his advice on this. He shared that information with us. We shared that with the applicant, and that's not what's being followed. So
it's up to the applicant.
That's the only issue.
Get the titles.
If the
issue straightened out.
If the,
I mean, that's the same thing he says, isn't it? I think.
But it's the responsibility of the applicant to perform, to prove title and ownership, and some of those things have been done.
But I just did. I just gave you the titles of my land, the deeds.
This is what exists now.
That's right, that's what exists.
Now, if she came in with a letter from her lawyer, signed letterhead from her lawyer, stating that he went to the Registry of Deeds and said, this is what exists now, would that suffice?
I'm sure that, I mean, that look, that appears to be a legal, you know,
I
mean,
it's legal. I mean,
it's not the original deed, but it doesn't need to be. So I'm confident that Mr. Petrinos is the owner of those three lots. That's not the issue. Like I said, the only issue that I have is that we have asked for particular direction and recommendation.
And that's why I was just asking that question.
That's all. So, well, it's not my decision. It's a board decision, so whatever you guys are comfortable doing.
No, that's why I'm asking the board. I mean, would that suffice?
Well, that pretty much follows the direction requested in the letter. Submit application for relief from planning board prepared by land use attorney, which addresses the regulatory issues which are within the planning board's jurisdiction. And then upon receipt of an application in proper legal form, and so if a lawyer gives us verification that he went to the Registry of Deeds and these are proper, to me that is supporting the proper legal form, okay, and supporting any required
surveyor will
exhibit.
Look at that as well, yes.
And it would be backed up by a surveyor.
That's right.
Any feeling, comments? Are you okay with that?
Yeah, that
sounds
perfectly.
I mean, I think that's following.
Yeah, logical to me.
Following our recommendation.
Reasonable.
Okay.
Because it would be a registered letter from the from the lawyer.
So I can do that. I'm sure I can meet you tomorrow and get that. So that won't be a problem.
So you'll have it by the next meeting then, correct?
Yeah, because we want to have Burton Engineering asked to be list of the abutters because they want to send out to the people that he needs to send it out to. So we were hoping by the 16th, everyone, that would be when the people would come in if they had any problems.
Yeah, you want to make sure that you get us an application before anything's sent out.
Well,
so.
Burton Engineering filled out the application.
Okay.
So I just have to give him a check for $200, and that's all set.
Okay, and you'll get that to Don. I mean, you said that it needs to be presented to us at a meeting, and I thought that's what tonight was for, but...
I thought so, too, but I guess they haven't finished it.
Okay, but I guess my question is, does that now need to be presented to us at the next meeting, or can you accept that in your office, or what?
With the board's consent, we can accept it in the office. The statute reads... Planner's submission date is the date that it's submitted to the board at a meeting.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I'm comfortable that you understand what an application. I'm comfortable that you understand what a completed application looks like, and that you'll get the proper fees for that if there are any, and can advise us that you've received that. That's your advice to us, Don.
Let's see exactly how it reads. Notice to the clerk of such city or town by delivery by or registered mail, postage prepaid, that he has submitted such a plan. If the notice is given by delivery, the clerk shall, if requested, give a written receipt therefore to the person who delivered such notice. This notice shall describe the land to which the plan relates sufficiently for identification, and shall state the date when such plan was submitted, and the name and address of the owner of such land. And the facts stated in such notice shall be taken by the city or town clerk as true unless the contrary is made to appear. Before approval, modification, and approval, or disapproval of the definitive plan is given, a public hearing shall be held by the planning board. Notice of the time and place of which and of the subject matter sufficient for identification shall be given by the planning board at the expense of the applicant by advertisement, newspaper, general circulation, the city or town once in each of two successive weeks, etc. By posting notice in the city or town hall 14 days before the day of the hearing, mainly a copy of the advertisement, the applicant, all owners of land, abutting in the land. The planning board may hold a definitive plan hearing together with the public hearing required by Section 9 of Chapter 48 as a special permit. That's not yet.
What was that last sentence? The planning board may what?
It's not applicable.
So you can receive the application?
I think with the board's authorization, I can receive the application.
Sorry?
I think with the board's authorization.
With the authorization.
Okay.
The board's understanding.
Based on your understanding of that, I have no issue with you receiving the application personally.
Also, it has to be filed.
It's fine, I think.
Copy has to be filed with the Board of Health, and the Board of Health has 45 days to comment. If they don't comment within 45 days, they have no comment.
Yeah, well, that's fine. You've answered the question then. The question is, sounds like with our authorization, you can receive the application, so that will save the applicant some time rather than waiting for the next meeting to submit the application. You can receive it when it's available. And then their engineer can go forward with sending a note out to the abutters, and then we can schedule the public hearing. Correct, Don?
That's correct.
Okay.
So the next meeting would be the public hearing meeting.
So when would the public hearing be done?
If we get it tomorrow, we can advertise.
If we can get what tomorrow?
We get the whole plan tomorrow.
The whole plan, what about the application?
That's what I mean, the whole application.
All right, the application, but that doesn't include the plan, does it? Yes? Okay. Okay, if we get it tomorrow.
I can run the local paper, I have to run the Worcester paper, but.
Those are details that.
Paper ad, Monday and the following Monday.
Okay. What is the deadline that Ms. Petrinos has to get the application and drawing to you so that she can hold a, so that we can hold a public hearing on her behalf at our next scheduled planning board meeting? What is that date?
It'll be Friday.
Friday. So, if you can get the application, the plan to us, by Friday.
I'm not scheduled to be here on Friday, though, so if we can get it by tomorrow, that's much better.
Okay. But she can submit it to the town clerk, right? Is tomorrow an issue, or?
I'm going to call them. I called there today, and they were both out. But I believe it should be done.
Okay.
The final thing is done for the land. And I know he filled out the applications, and I know he called the abutters office yesterday, so.
Okay, so it sounds like it possibly could be available, ready tomorrow.
If I have to go pick it up, I will.
All right. Don, are you in the office tomorrow? What are your hours?
About 12 to 7 tomorrow.
12 to 7. So if you have it tomorrow, he'll be in the office 12 to 7. If not, I guess you could submit it to the town clerk, but we would certainly recommend that you
submit. I need the information to write the hearing notice.
Okay.
I need at least the information, so we don't have the whole.
All right. So let's do this then. Ms. Petrinos, if you can't get it to him tomorrow between the hours of 12 and 7, then we'll have to push the public hearing off from.
That's 14.
November 16th to, and there's only one meeting in November?
That's right.
Oh boy. To December 14th.
No, I don't want to do that. So
oh.
I think I'm hoping he'll have it done tomorrow.
Okay. So just know that we're on record here, just so that we're all clear that if you can get that application and the drawing complete 100% to town planner tomorrow between the hours of 12 p.m. and 7 p.m., then we will hold the public hearing on November 16th. And if it's after tomorrow, then the public hearing will be held on December 14th.
Something I just want to clarify, and just, you know, for your own information. Plan shall, this is section 810, chapter 41 of the general laws. A plan shall be submitted under this section when delivered at a meeting of the board or when sent by registered mail to the planning board. If so mailed, the date of receipt shall be the date of submission of such of the plan. I mean, I don't think we really have to jump through that. I think we can just accept it tomorrow, knowing that it's coming in. Agreed?
Yeah.
Well, it's going to come down here. You said, because I asked him, he's like, oh, I'm going to go down there to the town hall. That was the date, like today, I didn't get him, and I talked to him yesterday. He goes, oh, I want to go down there. They said to him, oh, you know, I got to pay for the fees and everything. He's like, well, can do it together, you know, like, I'll let you know when I'm going down there with the applications and the...
This is Peter from Burton Engineering?
Yeah.
Okay. And he was referring to tomorrow?
He was saying, yeah, I would assume it was tomorrow.
Okay.
So, I'll call him first thing in the morning, he's there early, because I know they leave by like 3.
Right. So why don't you do this? Regardless of whether you can make it or can't make it, why don't you phone the planning office and just let Don know, I'm gonna be there between 12 and 7, or I'm not gonna be there. That way, you guys can make some arrangements if it's something other than that.
Yeah, I will.
Okay. We clear?
Thank you very much.
All right, you're welcome.
At least we've gotten somewhere.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Do I need to sign this?
If you can just sign in, that would be great. Just your name and address, and that's perfect.
John, do you want those? I have copies at the house. Okay, so...
There was the file copy, do you want a letter?
Yeah. You're all set?
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
Yep.
Have a good
day. I appreciate it, believe me. Thank you. Don't forget that they're right here, Don.
Yep, we'll get those. Thank you. All right. Where's my agenda?
Yes, one.
Come on.
Take it. No. I took it. Here it is, sorry.
Okay.
No, I took his.
Okay, so... Moving on to item C, reaffirm vote of October 12th to accept a lot release fee and release lot 80 from covenant held on Rocky Hill Estate subdivision. Don, will you want to give us a little bit of an overview on that one, please?
Well, on October 11th, was it actually?
12th, I think.
12th. Mr. Chinaki.
Chinaki, yep.
Submitted a check requesting release of lot 80. It's the standard procedure he's been following for some time. Every time he releases a lot from the building, he gives us a check of $1,000, right? Okay. And he had a check for the release of lot 80. And I said, you know, maybe you could come into the planning board meeting and describe what you're doing with the subdivision and where you're at and what your progress is and when you plan on finishing and where, you know, what construction you're doing at this point in time. So he did come into the meeting. And
which meeting?
That meeting, the 12th.
Oh, okay. Okay.
After the board, took a vote to accept the check.
Thank you. Might be better to bend that other one over.
And to release the lot. But then afterwards, the board. This one works better?
Yeah, that's good.
This one works better?
You don't have to reach as much.
Okay.
Good.
It's all relative, I guess. Yeah, so the board took a vote to release the lot based on having received the lot release fee of $3,000. Then there was some question about whether or not that should be done because it wasn't on the agenda, per se. But I checked with the Attorney General's office, and they said that if the board doesn't feel comfortable with it, they could re-vote it, but that's fine to do it that way because it wasn't anything that the chairman could have anticipated would be on the agenda notice within 48 hours because of the time frame with the holiday and what have you. It was okay to leave it, but they suggested that if the board didn't feel comfortable, but it could always be revoted at this meeting.
Okay.
Reaffirmed, whatever you want to call it.
So
I have a model motion over there too.
So based on that information, Don, should I assume that if there's not an agenda item, we can cover that topic during the planning board meeting?
If it's an item that the chairman couldn't reasonably anticipate being present for the agenda within 48 hours before the agenda was posted.
Okay. So that's pretty arbitrary.
You could say that. I mean, I wouldn't vote on anything controversial.
Okay. Okay.
The lot release is not particularly controversial.
Fair enough. What's the board's pleasure?
Well, if the Attorney General's good with it, I don't see a problem with it. but if the board, I mean, I was the one that brought it up, saying I didn't feel comfortable with it because it wasn't on the agenda, but I wasn't sure where that would fall into play.
Mm-hmm.
So we could rescind it and redo it, or we can just let it go as is.
I'm not even sure that it's suggested that it be rescinded. It's just to take a revote.
Just
revote on it, right?
Reaffirm
it.
The word that you generally use.
You'd just take another vote. And
the other thing is we didn't have, like, tax books, pages, that type of thing, and we only had Lot 80 of Eagle Drive.
Okay.
So at least now we have the Rocky Hill Estates.
So your feeling is we should reaffirm it?
Personally, yes.
Okay.
The page after
I
that
agree
is a
because
model,
we didn't have the detail. We didn't have the book number, any pages or anything. So,
okay.
Yeah.
I think it should be reaffirmed.
Yep.
There's no harm.
Great. So I'm looking to, I'm entertaining a motion to reaffirm our pass vote from October 12th to accept a lot release fee and release Lot 80 from a covenant held on the Rocky Hill Estate subdivision.
Second that motion.
Okay, so let's read that motion.
I'm going to read it.
Okay,
right now. To reaffirm the vote of October 12th, to reaffirm that on Eagle Drive, it's out of Worcester District Registry of Deeds, book 10797, page 49, and book 16067, page 132. As to the plan entitled Rocky Hill Estates, recorded with said deeds, plan book 623, plan 67, and that would be Lot 80 of Eagle Drive, Dudley, Massachusetts.
Okay, we have a motion.
I'll second that motion.
We have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Unanimous? Okay. Thank you, and thank you.
The release form can be signed now. I think that.
So what?
I think one member will have to go before, say, the town clerk or a notary to sign it. So maybe we can have someone sign, put up a notary tomorrow. But the rest of you can sign that release form.
That's right. For me?
Yes.
Okay. You need one copy? You can sign it. We're all going to sign it.
Whoever's going to sign in front of the notary tomorrow.
Oh,
she didn't sign
who is?
Today. I don't know. I think.
I'll take it down.
Oh, I'm sorry. I misunderstood.
Yeah.
So we all. Whoever is not going to sign it in front of the notary can sign it tonight, right?
Whoever is going to sign in front of the notary can't sign it tonight.
Correct. All
right.
Put it
the other way. Yeah, right.
I'll bring it down.
Thank you very much.
Might as well just sign right on the page. We'll make her on the bottom there.
How do you do it? I have. Crazy week going right now.
I'll be glad to do it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. And moving on to item, and thank you, Sean, for bringing that up. And it's very important as we need to make sure that we just continue to do the right thing relative to voting and. You know, an item that's not on the agenda should be glaring to every one of us, and appreciate you bringing
it up. Again,
it
was just a question. I mean, it was kind of a busy meeting in that sense also, and not seeing it there and just going to it, so.
Yeah, it's not pointing any fingers at anybody, just it was, you know, it's important that we recognize those things. That's the sort of stuff that can get us in trouble. Okay, item D, draft updates to subdivision regulations.
When I was going through, I told you that I would be reviewing the deposits we had on hand for financial guarantees. The only thing we have is these escrow accounts for the most part. We have a lender's agreement done under the standard format for a portion of Pierpont Estates, but that's about it. And apparently over the years, developers are building up to a certain point, typically the base coat, the first coat of pavement of the roadway, and releasing lots one at a time based on a fee for the rest of the subdivision until it was built out. It's not the way it's usually done. Typically, either the developer will post a bond to cover the entire cost of the subdivision, or a financial agreement of some kind, a cash deposit, or a bank passbook, or maybe a letter of credit, to cover the security for the remainder of the subdivision. Like, say, for example, well, subdivision, you know, however many lots, say, 8 lots, 10 lots, were built up to the roadway, were built up to the first coat of pavement. Typically, developer might post financial security of some kind, typically even a cash deposit, cover the expenses for the remainder of the subdivision construction, up through and including the final as-built plans and the street acceptance plans that we go to town meeting. That hasn't been happening here, so recommend from here on out, use these forms and these types of guarantees. If you look through the forms that I have, the samples, this is from the Mass Federation of Planning and Appeals Board. It's been out there for a long time. It was last updated, I think, in 2002. Typically, we fill those forms out and you see the form after the covenant. That's pretty similar to what we use typically, but I didn't see anywhere in the records, for the most part, where these forms were used to put a performance guarantee in the form of cash or in the form of an insurance policy, whatever it may be, a bond, insurance bond.
So it wouldn't be all of these documents, it would be one of these documents, one of either them. A bank passbook or an insurance or...
Right, and that covers the remainder of the work within the entire subdivision.
Yep.
Or all the lots released to date. Say, for example, it's common to release one street at a time.
Right. So, for instance, on an insurance policy or a bank passbook, what happens if the applicant decides to close the bank passbook or doesn't pay the premium on the insurance policy? How are we insured to be notified?
If they don't pay the insurance, the premium policy, the insurance company will get back to us and give us 30 days notice that we're canceling this policy.
Okay.
If it's a bank passbook, sometimes they're a problem. I wouldn't recommend doing a bank passbook. I would recommend a cash deposit in the town's name,
okay,
whatever you can. You have to be careful with the passbook because if it says or, and even if you hold it in the treasurer's office, probably the applicant can come along and take it out of the treasurer's office and cash it in.
Okay.
With a deposit slip.
So based on...
What some towns do is take a withdrawal slip, signed by the applicant, hold it with the town treasurer in the passbook. I don't know, there's all kinds of ways to do it, but
so
the most secure thing is cash.
Basically, you're saying if the town treasurer held the passbook.
Town treasurer will hold the passbook. And
he would have to come in, fill out a form.
We would have to fill out a form to release it.
To release that.
However,
reduce it.
This was 2002. Passbooks used to be in existence in 2002. I don't think they use passbooks anymore. I think it's all electronic or whatever. So
you call it a passbook account just the same, but it isn't the old fashioned you used to put in the machine and stamp
right.
it. And
right.
But there's a physical document, I guess is my point. And if the town treasurer is going to hold on to a physical document, I'm okay with that. But I don't think that that would be the case in today's day and age with a passbook.
It is.
It is.
Whatever,
okay.
Whatever it is,
okay.
The town treasurer will hold the original form.
Okay.
It's going to be an agreement that the money is there to finish the subdivision in the event the developer defaults.
Okay.
The other thing, too, is you might want to put a time frame on it because for a couple of reasons. For one, the money gets beaten up with inflation. If you post something that's, say, good for construction costs, theoretically for 2 years, the subdivision goes 15 years, it'll be worth the amount of money that you put in the first place. You have to keep an eye on the amount of money that's in the passbook, too.
Right. So it sounds to me like the passbook piece is one that is probably the most risky of all. And based on that, Ian, not sure exactly how that would work without a physical document. So based on that, what if we just eliminated the passbook option?
I'm not sure how that works because the statute says you can accept the passbook.
Okay. Okay.
So you run these things by town council to make sure that the agreements are tight.
No, that's fine. I mean, I'm just saying, if it was easy to just remove that, then if that's the riskiest, that would be my recommendation. But if you're saying that it's part of the statute, then we just leave it in there. I really don't want to, I'd prefer not to pad the clock of town attorney. I think we've worn that out, but anyway, I like your recommendation.
I can tell you this much, some towns I've worked in have letters of credit. One town council said we won't accept letters of credit because it's not a negotiable security under that section in the statute. Some towns prefer them, some towns say no.
Okay.
That's one, and also,
you want to be
covered. I tell you too that I saw a situation where a bank passbook was posted and very clearly said that in the event that subdivision isn't finished, the town can use the money remaining in the passbook to finish the subdivision, et cetera. Time came around, the bank said, nope, we won't release it to you. It's ours. They went to court, but
okay.
We don't want to do that anymore.
All right. So, what is the board's pleasure? Do you want to take these documents home, review them? Are you comfortable providing the planner with recommendations on, you know, let's go for it, or what do you want to do?
So we're supposed to choose one of these?
No, it would be all of them.
Okay.
So the applicant wouldn't be forced to use all of them, it would be one of them. So my bond
one of them or
is
possibly a combination of them.
My bond is going to be an insurance policy, as long as that's the adequate amount that we're looking for to cover the finishing of the subdivision if for some reason it's not. So it sounds to me like the town planner just said that maybe it's partial in a passbook, partial in an insurance policy, and some cash. Or maybe it's all in a passbook, maybe it's all in an insurance policy.
Maybe different streets have different types of bonding too, that's possible.
Okay.
Big subdivision, you typically would probably bond once a year at a time.
Okay.
So would this pertain to just new subdivisions, or would the...
Here on out, I don't think we should be doing that escrow system anymore.
Yes, any existing are already grandfathered the way they're already been.
So they said something new.
We can't make a change to that unless the applicant's willing to come in, and I can't imagine why they would be.
Oh, my question is, does the planning board have authority to approve this, or do we have to vote to approve it and then bring it to the
no,
Board of
Selectmen?
No, regulations
and the subdivision control law both allow you to these forms.
Okay.
So it's in our purview to make this change, the planning board, without any authorization of...
That's right. Okay.
Very good.
Fill in the blanks, you know, I can... Oh, this is 19-something, so... Old, but
1972.
Oh. Well, my recommendation would be that we obviously kind of
just
put this rebuild this form so it's electronic,
right?
And I would imagine you would want to do that as well, right? Yeah, okay. Okay, so
in the other section, we talked about putting two sets of regulations side by side. One thing I noticed in the regulations is that there's not much in there about the performance guarantee. We've been through that. I used an example of the town of Burlington, some of the sections of their regulations that are similar and a little bit more detailed than we have in that regard. So Dudley is on the left. Burlington as a sample is on the right. In some cases, there's nothing really compatible with it because they have more wording than we do. Calculation the amount of guarantee, how they do it, procedures for release of reduction, performance guarantee, partial release of a covenant, partial release of a surety.
Okay, so this is subdivision rules and regulations.
That's right.
All right. And the existing is on the left side, and then the subject that we'd like to duplicate is on the right side, which is what you said, Burlington, Town of Burlington?
Yeah, they have a good set of regulations particularly, I think. Very,
okay.
Very comprehensive.
And so the planner is proposing that we adopt the plans on the right for our new subdivision rules. And same question that Marcia asked, this is in our purview to make a change without authorization of any other boards or officials.
Just after a hearing. Hearing and public notice, it's regulations, it's not a bylaw. So it doesn't have to go before a town meeting or.
Okay.
Also, a little bit further down in that section too, record drawing and acceptance plans. I compare that to what they require. There's not much detail in here about what we require for acceptance plans for streets. Upon completion of the subdivision, a lot more detail and on the right-hand page of all that could be accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen that there were a lot of subdivision streets that aren't totally finished and haven't been accepted. I have a whole list of them too. Actually, section E in your binder. I have the town planner's report. And I also have the status of those escrow accounts, subdivisions they're for.
So does our subdivision plan really say Indian ink on linen?
Yeah. Yeah, Indian ink on linen.
That's old, huh?
Well, I haven't seen linen paper.
I
used to use it at a land court.
Okay. Say so.
You get to use linen paper.
Maybe it's time,
mistake,
huh?
You're in trouble. You gotta start over again. Used to still use the linen paper for land court up to about.
That should go on to the historical society.
Okay, so does the board want to review those subdivision recommendations as well?
I would recommend that.
Yeah, I prefer to review them before.
I think that's something that's got to be really looked at.
Yeah.
Pretty soon.
Okay.
We don't get into a bind anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and as far as some other things, there's some standards we could revise, some environmental development standards and what have you.
Okay.
Revise as we go along, but it's probably better to address this first.
All right. So I'm in agreement with that, but I'd also like to make one other recommendation since, you know, our board reports into Board of Selectmen. I think that it probably would be a good courtesy to them to just share.
Sure.
This information with them, indicating that we're looking at
absolutely
adopting these. And would you be able to do that?
Sure.
All right. I'm also going to suggest that we be prepared to speak about this so that we can act fairly quickly and not allow any additional subdivisions come in under our old program or old regulations, that we be prepared to do this for our next meeting, which is what, November 16th?
Yes. Prepare to schedule a hearing that night.
Huh?
You prepare to schedule a hearing that.
Yeah, but
night, yeah.
I'd like to recommend to the board that we be prepared to approve or ask questions about this that night as well, so we can adopt them and you can put them in place. Just in case something comes up, right? You want this sooner rather than later is what I'm hearing.
If you want to adopt that, then I have to schedule a hearing for that night.
Oh.
So what I'm saying
is that
if everybody
can
look through this and sort of get an idea, you know, sort of a workshop format type discussion we can have on the 16th, and then from there take it to the hearing.
Okay.
Which may very well be the first or second week in January at this point.
So we do have a public hearing?
So I don't think anybody's going to want to have a public hearing the week after Christmas.
Right. Yes, that's what I'm hearing. So we have to have a public hearing to make these changes, to adopt
not
these.
Not to adopt the forms, because that's not part of the regulation per se. That's just a.
Okay. Why do we have to have a public hearing then?
Make the changes to the text of the sections that I put side by side.
Okay.
So could we?
That's the text.
Could we move forward on the bonding part?
No, on just don't accept any. It's technically, it's in the regulations, but it's not as clear as it could be. And these haven't been used by this town for some reason, whatever reason they haven't been used by this town. Most towns use these forms or variation of them.
But the question is, next meeting, can we all agree, if we all agree, we have some questions or whatever, but we decide that we want to start using this new form for subdivisions, that we can do without a public hearing, correct?
That's correct.
All right.
Form, they're not part of the regulations, they're just an agreement, like, you know, a contract, whatever you want to think of it as.
Okay. So, yeah, let's come prepared to, with questions or ready to approve or disapprove the use of these forms for our next meeting. And then questions, kind of a, just a working meeting regarding the subdivision rule changes. And then that we will have to have a public hearing for. And we'll schedule that sometime in January.
It's occurred to me that you may not, I didn't realize this until recently, but you may not all have copies of the regulations.
Of the subdivision regulations?
Yeah.
Well, don't we have them here?
Or an entire, a complete copy.
I think I do. I have the book. But
if any of you don't have it, let me know. I'll give you a copy of that.
I don't have it.
I can also give you a copy of the planner's handbook, so-called, which summarizes everything that planning boards do. You might not want to read every page, but, you know, again, let's hear.
Maybe something.
You have insomnia that night, but.
Yeah.
I can email that to you.
That'd be great.
It'd be quite a bit to print, so I can email that. And it's a very good summary of just what planning boards do.
That would
Some of it's
wonderful.
A little bit dated, but it's not so dated that it doesn't make any sense anymore. Maybe a few technicalities have changed, but it gives you a pretty good idea of what planning boards do with flow charts and.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, and that's what we were talking about the other night relative to Pam, since she's the newest board member, to provide some sort of orientation for her relative to the booklets and documents and different things. Is that what you were just referring to?
I didn't realize
well?
It may not have been done, so.
Oh, that's
so
good.
We'll work on that.
Okay.
And anyone else? Anyone else interested in those? I don't know.
I have a very brief summary I used to do, like a one-page summary. Book
sure, I'll take one.
I'll see if I can get hold of that one.
All right.
Another place I used to work.
Yeah, and I don't need the full stack, but yeah, if you have an overview, and I think that would be good to just review. Okay. All right, good. Well, Don, thank you for looking at that. I mean, these are exactly the things that we talked to you about during our interview process, and that, you know, we really need to look at things differently and bring the town of Dudley up to speed relative to subdivisions and bylaws and different things as it relates to the planning board. So
I can't tell you how important it is to have enough money left over when the subdivision fails.
Yeah. No, absolutely, for sure. And you also promised something about economic development, so we're waiting on that too.
I'm working on that too. In fact, today I went to another session. I'm working on it with Greg too. Town administrator.
Okay.
Try to get some funding in place to jumpstart it and
be great.
Get from there. Essentially, what I would hope we might be able to do is to update the economic development chapter of our master plan. That's what it all will amount to. How we intend to do it. This town, you know, every town's unique, has their own needs and their own resources.
Okay. Did you have a question or a comment?
I was just going to say that I know he attends the Economic Development Committee meetings in town.
Nice. Okay. Moving on. Planner's plate. You want to skip that, Don? That would be okay with me.
Okay, you can read it.
I'll read it. Any comments from the planning board? No? No one from the audience. Only other business that we can talk about later is Village District Walk. That's something that we've been trying to plan for a while. Approval of consultant vouchers, payments of bills.
We have one here.
Okay, we'll sign that. Other town notices, that's in our other business. You certainly can look at that. Different things that Webster and Oxford are doing. Recent changes to the Zoning Act. Master and the Law, Chapter 40.
I didn't give a very good summary of that last meeting. I just can go over that very quickly.
Okay.
There's an addition to Chapter 40A, Section 7, which has more to do with
statute of limitations and zoning violations, which probably has more to do with building inspectors than with the planning board, so I'll get much more ado on that one. I think we'll get into that too much. One major thing is that special permits expire within 2 years. The statute now reads 3 years. So that's something that, if no action is taken, the special permit expires within 3 years, not two. That's the other major change, and it's really it. It's in addition to Section 6 of Chapter 48 as well, which pertains to grandfathering, which typically has more to do with the building inspector enforcing zoning regulations, zoning bylaw.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it, really, in the zoning.
Okay, regarding this voucher for Webco, we received that money from them because that's an applicant expense, right?
It goes into our engineering review.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's right.
Right?
We received a $500 payment from them.
From Webco?
Yes.
Okay.
We received a $500 payment. The amount is what, $480, something like that?
$485, $65, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Other correspondence. I think we're done. So our next scheduled meeting is Wednesday, November 16th. I hope to see the same robust audience that we had tonight. Entertaining a motion to adjourn.
Tomorrow, and this just gets done.
I make a motion to adjourn.
We got a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Say aye. Opposed? Good night. Thanks, Fred.
Thank you, Fred.